Very fitting that you're here, very strong lady yourself, three daughters. Is that kind of the main reason why you wanted to get involved in this?
In some respects, but it's sort of not just about them, it's about all of us. I think we're all born feeling like we're part of, we equally share the world. And I think as you grow up, you can become quite disillusioned with the way things run. And that kind of disillusionment and dissatisfaction needs a voice, and things need to change. So that you don't become bitter and jaded, you need to do something about it, I think. And this is an opportunity for everybody to think about what it is that's needed. They're kind of equal opportunities for education and health, everything.
And a great message for your daughters. I mean, is this the type of thing you do talk to them about and tell them, you know, we're doing this, and did you know that, you know, two-thirds of the women in the world are
a little... Absolutely. We have conversations like this all the time. My daughters are very grown up, and they equally are quite knowledgeable. They have a great knowledge of history and experience themselves, even though they're quite young. And we talk about it a lot. It's difficult for women. You have to be better. You would know this yourself. I'm quite sure getting the position you've got, you've known that you're going to have to be better than a male counterpart to get it.
Do you think, I mean, female inequality kind of exists the world over, and in showbiz, I think female celebrities get treated different to male celebrities in the way that it's focused on the way they dress, how big they are, how small they are, and the guys never ever get that.
No, I mean, it's quite shallow, but that's because women, it's been very easy to dismiss them because we're not that outspoken about things. You know, we are willing to just have more elegance about everything and be quieter and sit in the background. And why should we? I have absolutely no idea. We should be demanding exactly the same kind of rights and the same kind of level of judgment as anybody else. So, I've been lucky though. I've been in an industry that doesn't really do that.
Yeah, you have. Yeah, and also you're, you know, very well respected within that industry as well. Hugely.
Very lucky. Yeah.
And Simon, your husband's performing tonight. He's on stage with Timbaland. Those two are friends, aren't they? And I always thought that's a kind of a funny friendship. It's one of those unlikely friendships that you wouldn't imagine.
There are all sorts of unlikely friendships in the music industry. That's the great thing about music, is it just brings people together from everywhere. And they work together. I mean, they did a couple of albums ago, Timbaland, you know, produced quite a lot of tracks on the album, so they worked together really happily, got on really well, and this seemed like such a great thing to do, and Timbaland, you know, thought thing, it's great.
And obviously Beyonce headlining. Did you know Beyonce? I mean have you been hanging backstage?
No, the backstage is kind of big here. It's Twickenham. Everybody's dressing rooms are pretty spread out, I've got to say. But it's great fun and great fan, you know. There have been some really cool people on. To be honest, I've missed a lot of them, so I'm going to have to watch it all back, but that's okay.
Boo. Oh, well, enjoy the rest of the night. Thank you so much, Yasmin.
Pleasure.
Cheers. Thank you.